the people who pay for healthcare are alarmed by what they see as their risk on the horizon for taking care of cancer patients. Not that they're not absolutely delighted that people are getting better, and actually, I think, and I can't believe I can say this, people are getting cured now. But the population's aging, and cancer is a disease of aging, and the cost of therapies has gone up substantially. Now, while we can embrace the improvement in outcomes, we have to be very realistic about what that means for how much of our dollars as members of health plans, or how much of our federal government's budget is going to healthcare. And I think one solution that has proposed, and it won't be the only, is the idea that you should pay a fair price for a fair outcome. Moving from a system right now, which is fee-for-service, where people get paid more for doing more, irrespective of outcome. And I think if you say that to a normal person, normal Joe, it makes perfect sense. The devil, though, is really, truly in the details. In oncology, I think oncologists are more than happy to embrace the idea of moving to a system where they get more fairly reimbursed for a better outcome. Oncologists absolutely hate being tainted by the increasing cost of imaging, testing, therapies. They feel it's unfair, and I totally understand that. But on the other hand, they have to own the fact that they hold the mightiest sword of all, the prescribing pen. I would say that the volume to value transition in oncology has been challenging. There have clearly been speed bumps. I think we can look at the OCM, for example, as a volume to value transitional experiment. We've now gone through not quite 2 years of the program. We've had one reconciliation on the bonus payment model, which has created a lot of very unhappy people. We have some learning to do. On the one hand, and CMMI has said this repeatedly, we really have started to examine how we deliver care and improve on it. That is wonderful. I think we have yet to get our hands around the medical and cost inflation, which is associated with, at this point, the cost of innovation. So I said yesterday, I don't have a dog in this fight. I am a very interested observer, and I've devoted a lot of my life to trying to help figure this out in a fashion that was good for oncologists. I'm oncology blood runs through my veins. I'm a community oncologist through and through. So we'll see.